Well, belated Merry Christmas, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. We just had my Maisie kind of want to be in the video. So anyway, I hope you all had a great Christmas. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, welcome and hello. I have had my fill of playline mishaps, misfits, and everything in between. Between fresh dolls and Barbie Extra and being on the hunt, using tons and tons of money and time and gas trying to find dolls that aren't scratched and have wonky eyes and chipped lip paint and everything else in between, I decided to go back to my roots, back to vintage. That's where I started collecting dolls was vintage Barbie. And then I discovered clones along the way. So I thought I would have just a little bit of fun going back in time, kind of getting back to my roots with vintage. And I want to show you guys my latest pre-Christmas eBay vintage doll haul. So let's take a look and see what I got for only 50 bucks. This auction ended at an off time, so it really benefits you. If you look at auctions that end at off times when people are too busy either at work or doing dinner or in a commute home, when you find those auctions that end in those off times, you usually do pretty well. So who do we have here? Let's take a look and see what I got. So we have a Barbie clone doll. Her name is Annette. She's from the Eegee company of the early to mid 60s. And her predecessor was a Miss Babette. Now, I saw this lot on eBay. Starting bid was $50. And I had some communications with the seller prior to the end of the sale, just asking questions about this doll. And this is her childhood doll. I don't know the lady's name. I just know her seller name. But this was her childhood doll put away in storage that she decided to sell because she's getting older. And she says that there's no one to bequeath her dolls onto. So she thought she would just kind of sell some and make some money. So this is a Titian, one of the harder to find Titian Annettes with the bangs. And so I thought we'd take a look at her and the other things I got with her. So she is 11 and a half inches tall. She has that was my shoe squeaking, by the way. I'm kneeling in front of my dining room table where my background is, and I just slipped. But anyway, so she comes in at 11 and a half inches and has a hollow blown body. The difference between her and her predecessor, Miss Babette, is Miss Babette had these chubby baby doll arms that had starfish hands. That's what they called it. And I think what they did when Eegee introduced Babette, I think they had extra pieces from their little baby dolls or maybe toddler dolls or maybe the Tammy clone type dolls where they had these arms and they decided to stick them on a fashion doll body and use them up. That's what I think. Then when they were gone, I think they finally designed the more slender arms of Miss Annette here. She, I think she's more rare because she wasn't made as long as Miss Babette was. So here she comes in. She is wearing her original earrings. She has a ponytail, but not probably in the original set that she came in. More likely her owner did it up in that cute little rag there. It's cute. Not mad at it. Now this doll, when I look at her, she is way over-rooted. The plugs are too big and they rooted her past her ear. So this gal has a ton of hair. It is probably rooted along just the perimeter of her skull like Barbie was, just to make the ponytail with no rooting in between. She has the very dark eyeliner with the cat eye, which really I love about these Annettes. She has high color blush, but I see she has like a little bit of fading on one cheek. She's wearing a Mattel vintage Barbie play suit. The belt is probably Mattel, I'm not quite sure. Now, mind you, I've done nothing with these dolls. They just came in the mail a few days ago, and they do have that musty kind of stored in the attic kind of smell, which I'm not mad at. But we're going to talk about what we're going to do to refurbish these finds. She is wearing Barbie clone mules. And she's just super cute. She spoke to me when I saw her. Her pictures weren't that great. She does have, because she was over-rooted, she does have
where she's rooted, maybe some splitting at the hairline. So we're going to discuss how we're going to salvage her, protect her, redo her hair, and it's going to be fun. So that's her. And then she came with, this to me looks like to be a mommy made outfit styled after the sheaths of the vintage sheaths that Mattel made for Barbie, those on the go sheaths. They have bigger buttons, and the back is made with buttons. So this is mommy made, but I feel it's whatever mommy made it, she had some F's to give, because she did a pretty good job. These are all going to have to be cleaned up, and I'm going to do video tutorials of how to clean up the clothes and how to clean up and redo the doll. So that'll be fun. This piece right here, this is a clone piece, I'm sure. I don't think it's Mattel. I don't think there's any tags in here. I'm not sure if this is a bathrobe or if this is like a hostess dress. I don't exactly know what this is, but everything here is in good shape. This gal really took good care of her doll and doll clothes. But it's cute. It's got little weird apples. I don't know like what year this would clock in at, but it's got to be maybe 60s. The piece de resistance is this either Fablu, but I'm assuming it's more probably a British Royal Colony, British Crown Colony, whatever that brand was that made. This is a brocade sheath with metallic threads to make up this colored pastel design with the matching coat with faux fur cuffs. And again, this doesn't have, I don't think this has the, I don't think it has the tag in it, but they are an outfit that goes together. Oh, you know what? I forgot something. Darn, I forgot a chunk of this. So I'll just have to like tag it at the end of this video because my editing skills suck. But anyway, so brocade, you have to be very careful in cleaning it. And I'm going to show you guys how I do it. I've done it before. This is in really nice shape. If it didn't have just that little kind of attic-y, kind of musty smell, I probably wouldn't bother. But I do like to kind of clean my stuff just to have it, when I put them in my clothing caboodle, so they don't make the whole thing musty. So I clean every piece of clothing that I buy off of eBay. And I'll show you how I do it. This is a mommy made, I don't know what this is. If it's like a shirt, it's it's cute. I don't know if it's fashionable, but it's cute. It looks like a little, maybe like a little doll play suit. Maybe, what are these? Are those like, what are those? Culottes or something, maybe? Mommy made culottes with elastic waist. This is, I believe, I have seen these before with M on them and B on them. So I'm not sure if this is an actual factory made. And it's a little bit dirty. It's going to get cleaned up. I don't know if this is actual factory-made clone cheerleader outfit or if this is actually a mommy-made one. I don't know. It needs a snap repair in the back. It needs to be cleaned. But it's cute. So I've seen them before with the red and the white kind of colors attached to them. Not attached to them. The red and white colors that they are. And so she could be a cheerleader. And then this is a for sure Mattel made on the go sheath. It's the green one. It has the silver buttons, but over time, some of the silver overlay has worn through and it just shows the glass bead. So, you know, if I want to, I could replace them, but there's something special about this doll and about these clothes. The fact that they came from that lady and they're hers from childhood, I really have a respect for what they are and who they came from. So I don't want to really change anything about it, just clean them up for my collection and clean her up. So I forgot a small chunk of this haul, so I'm going to grab it right now and then we'll look at it when I come back. So we are back. I grabbed that last little bit of this haul that I forgot to bring out the first time. So let's take a look. Now this piece right here, oops, in case you haven't seen it, this is her original blue striped bathing suit. Very similar, almost practically identical in fabric and pattern to the vintage Barbie 1 through 4. One through four, original bathing suit, the tiber, I think they call it zebra striped. So hers, Annette's came in blue, and this is original to her. I have a pink one as well in my collection. These shoes, upon doing some research, these yellow mules that, they're little stilettos, they clasp in the front. Here's the other one. And doing research on this outfit, I want to say it's maybe called Evening Glory. Those shoes actually came with that outfit, and there was like a little bundle of plastic flowers. So I have the majority of this entire outfit just in this lot for $50. We have one of those clone cameras. I've seen quite a few of these on eBay lately. And I just think they're interesting, and I don't know why suddenly they're a hit. Several pairs of white clone mules, similar to the ones that Barbie wore. Some hair curlers. This red clutch, which is completely mint, all complete. I believe this is probably Mattel. I don't think that's a clone piece, but I'll have to research it just in case. And this cute little piece right here, it's like a little, it obviously says a toaster. We know it's a toaster, but I can't do this one-handed. Otherwise, I'd show you that there's little blue bread in there. Isn't it cute? It's just cute. I don't know why I think this is so cute. It's only one slicer, but yet it has handles on both sides and like the bread pops up. I'm not sure if the bread comes out of the toaster altogether, but it's just a fun little piece. This was just all part of the whole dealio for $50. I think I did pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. So the next thing we'll be doing will be to clean these up, and I'm going to show you how I do it, which will be just more fun, I think. More fun stuff to do. But I thank you for tuning in today and just kind of checking out my little vintage haul. I have been so wrapped up in Playline and contemporary dolls between Meezy and Barbie and fresh dolls, you know, and kind of just fretting over, you know, them being perfect and going on road trips to find them, period, or find them perfect. And it's just nice to kind of just get back and just, you know, vintage is what it is. There is nothing perfect in the vintage world. And so, you know, when they're played with in love, you can forgive a lot of things that children do, but you certainly cannot forgive companies with Playline that just cannot get quality down. But I'm not going to try to be mad at it. I'm just going to enjoy the fact that I have this Annette here that I'm going to clean up, redo her hair. She's going to look so pretty. And maybe we'll make her, you know, this is a different diorama that I made for my One Modern Circle Barbie, their movie studio. It's also a nice little penthouse for Meezy and maybe for Barbie. It's got that mid-century kind of vibe to it. But maybe I'll make like a 19, early 60s, early 50s kind of cute little maybe diorama just for my vintage gals. So I might do that. Kind of, I wouldn't mind trying to find one patterned after the ideal cardboard house that was like used for the ideal Tammy doll. So cute. So that might be my inspiration. So anyway, I have yammered on enough. I appreciate you guys tuning in. And there I go squeaking again. Right on video. Anyway, that's my shoe. Don't be laughing. But this is my $50 haul from eBay with Miss Annette and her clothing items and accessories. So I'm really excited to kind of get cracking on cleaning her up. So we will be hopefully doing that soon. You guys enjoy your weekend, and I hope you had a Merry Christmas and have a safe upcoming New Year.